to describe Matt? I'd say he's very talented, very passionate man, very determined, and a very loyal person as well. I'd say he's very, very focused. He's one of the most focused people I've met. You know, anyone who achieves this level of success has to be extraordinary, which I guess, you know, is really gifted, talented. The most effective word is tenacious and hard work. I think going through the journey together, I think it's been fantastic that we've been able to share it together. There's been some tough times. I think there has to be always some tough times because the sweet doesn't taste as sweet without a bit of bitter. But when we've dealt with the bitter, we've dealt with it together and we've dealt with it as a united force. And he's unwavering in his support. I think as a partner, you couldn't ask for anything more than that. I think I center him a bit as well. I think we all need that. I think Sarah, his wife, and his two kids center him as well, as all families do. Personally, I think, you know, Matt's a godfather to my eldest daughter, who he's very tight with and very close with, and that's a pretty special thing for him and me. And he's close to my family, you know, so he's seen them grow up. He's seen them go through all those things. It's a pretty special relationship we have, I think.
What annoys me about Matt?
Mate, there could be heaps of them.
No, there's only one, actually.
Yeah, which one?
Limited attention span at times. Yeah,
that's...
But he's heard that before.
It's not uncommon in meetings that they actually take my phone off me. What am I thankful for? Look, that's pretty easy. Life. You know, I'm a pretty lucky person. Starting at 15 and being so young, and, you know, I was a kid from the suburbs, you know. I grew up in most of my life in Blacktown. Bit of a thug, not really knowing what I wanted to do in life. I fell into cooking. I saw things that I'd never seen before, and I saw what people were doing with food that I could never imagine you could actually do it with food. So I naturally fell in love with it, and being a bit, you know, compulsive, obsessive, I became obsessed with food. Now, when I started, there was no such thing as a celebrity chef or, you know, driving around in sports cars or working for airlines or even owning restaurants back in those days, and the chefs were the smelly, grubby guys out the back that no one really cared about. But to me, it was something that I just fell in love with. And I never really envisaged owning restaurants or writing cookbooks or being on TV. It was a progression, you know. I never set out to be that person. It just sort of happened organically. My life is pretty extraordinary, you know. I love my life. I've got amazing people, great family, you know, great colleagues. And often I hang out with my colleagues, you know, that are other famous chefs. And we have a drink sometimes and we scratch ourselves and think, how did this happen?